and Benson and Winter really throwing punches at one another.
Last year, the WHL looked at a game that was getting bigger, faster, and stronger than ever before, and instituted a 7-point plan with player safety at the forefront.
Benson loses the handle last minute, actually gets cross-checked into the net. PA takes exception to that, thinking that he's going after their goaltender here, but geez, he could have hurt himself, just missed that far post with his head.
So these are the helmets that we have for our league. They're CCM helmets. That's our league sponsor. And as you can see, there's two different types of foams that we use. The VN foam here is more like a pro type foam. It's a little bit thicker, denser foam. And this is what we call a concussion foam. It's an EPP foam. It kind of disperses energy once a player is hit. Our biggest concern is actual fit. I think that the biggest misconception out there that there's this helmet that's going to change the world and change everything in the game. But honestly, if helmet fits properly, that's the right helmet for a player.
During training camp, each player goes through balance and cognitive testing, which provides the Blades medical staff with a baseline for return to play. In addition to this league-mandated concussion protocol, Hildebrand says athletic trainers also have the advantage of familiarity.
With us, you know, as a team, I'm with these guys every day. I know them on a personal level. So if something happens on the ice where I think or suspect they may be concussed, I can handle that appropriately and know by their body language and what they're telling me and not telling me. Sometimes, you know, it may takes a little bit to settle in, but, you know, if he gets hit and I go down to him and say, how you doing? And he says, fine. You know, I trust that he is fine because I do know him on a more of a personal level.
We'll take a look at it here after the DD pass. They come in for support. Olsen comes to turn to protect the puck. Corbin comes in to make that hit. That's a tough play to hold up on.
Given the high-impact nature of hockey, there's always going to be potential for concussions, no matter what the innovations. That's why brain injury awareness is so important.
Well, you know, when you think about it, first of all, we ask families to allow these young men, their kids, to come to play in the Western Hockey League, to play in our club, and at anywhere from 16 to 20 years old, and it's our responsibility to look after them and make sure that we provide them as safe an environment as is possible. And if you want to look at it strictly, even from a purely business standpoint, they're our most important asset. The players, and it's important to us to look after them, and we take that very seriously. So we're really pleased with the initiative that the Saskatchewan Brain Injury Association has taken, and we're fully behind them in trying to get the brain injuries out of play for sure.
They play this game because they love it, and they always want to be on the ice. But more importantly, they also have a life to live. And down the road, they realize that this could affect them. So more and more players now are more willing to take care of their head than they were before. We still have those cases where we have guys who try and convince us, and with all the tools that we have now, it's helping us make better decisions on players. And I think moving forward, all the technology is only going to get better.
Lucas Sutter had a line on Cirelli, but now turned back up. Here's Nichols, in, shoot, scores!
For SIGA's Inside Edge, I'm Matthew Prefontaine on the road to the Memorial Cup.